history has been made here in West Bengal as a more than three-decade-old communist government is now firmly out of the way. Green is the color of Kolkata today, not red, with some people even saying that the writer's building should be painted green now. Well, we're about to talk to the heroine of the moment, the woman who's going to be the next chief minister of West Bengal, the first woman chief minister that the state has ever had. Mamtadi, I first must ask you, even I'm wearing green today, but you're wearing white. So how did that happen?
Green and white. Inside is green.
Inside is green.
Outside is white, means this is a chadar symbolically, you know, the minorities people, they donated me. So when I started my election day from Malda, that Savitri is winning from that seat. So they gave me this. It is a blessing. So I am wearing from the day one, the county, the election campaigning. So I preserve it. If you give me any blessings or dua, it is a duty to preserve it. That's why I am just preserving the blessings and dua of the people. But Bengal, obviously, it is not that we are against of leftists. It is the Marxist people, so-called Marxist. They totally deviated from the leftist ideology also. And because of their torture and rigging and atrocities within these years, even I am sorry to say, more than 75,000 people are killed, even after Lok Sabha election also. So I think this is not the proper politics. You may differ me politically or ideologically. That I don't mind. It is a democratic right for everyone. But we have to remember that we have to respect the political situation. We have to obey the constitutional obligation and all. Today I'm really happy that Jungle Mahal, what they blame us. Even Maoist people, Marxists and Maoists, they fight against us. Please remember, Maoist and Marxist together, they fought against us to cut the vote and all this, in the name of change and all this. We are happy that Jungle Mahal, it is a Trinamool Congress, no Maoist or the Marxist, it is the people.
You said in your opening statement that you are humbled, but you also want to remember the martyrs who've been fighting for three decades, and that this is a time to salute them. Who did you mean specifically?
I'm humbled always, because I said that I always want to be as a commoner. Because I have no family. Only one family is a human family. What I like to continue. And number two, of course, I salute to my martyrs, and also I salute to so many people who are not alive today. Their expectation also to see the Bengal. They said this is the second Independence Day. Though there was an independence, we are the independent country. But in Bengal, there is no democratic rights, not the political rights or the property rights. Even education institution, if you go, if you are not a CPM man, then you are not allowed to admit the institution. In this situation, how people, they have got their voting rights, I must congratulate the election commission and the team also. How they facilitated the people at least to cast their vote. Except few areas, very few, they allow the people to cast their vote. We salute to them also to restore the democracy. They are the main pillar. And today we are celebrating the festival of democracy. It is not me, it is the people of Bengal. And though I said that there is no peace rally, there is no, sorry, the victim, the procession and all this, because now we have to maintain the peace, I appeal everybody. I want everybody's cooperation in this regard. And from the government and from the opposition, we want to work together, no problem. And I want the CPM people also, I'm their revolution.
So you will reach out to the opposition as an opposition?
I said that. I said there is no differences. We belong to a common family. When there is a competition, there is an election. We must fight for the election. We must take the verdict of the people. But when people have given you the verdict, when you continue the government, that is for the people, of the people, by the people.
Didi, tell us a little bit about the morning. Were you nervous at all, or were you sure that you were going to win?
No, I'm not nervous because I don't feel that I'm fighting this battle for position. It is an action. It is a mission of the people, and there is a vision. It is not that for me. So why I'll be worried or the nervous when I know that I'm individual, it is not my anything to get. It is a public, the collective responsibility, collective family. They should be very well. And what they want, let their will should be, their intention should be.
But you've made history. You really have made history. This is, and you know, I heard some people outside saying this is like the fall of the Berlin Wall. You have, it's not just another election. When you heard the margin with which you had won, I think you always knew you were going to win. But when you saw the scale of the victory, what was the first thing that went through your mind? What was the, who was the first person you spoke to? Did you speak to your mother? Were you watching the results with your family?
I'm really humbled. I'm really obliged to all of my public, the democratic family, family of democracy. I bow down my head to Ma Mati Manush, what you said. It's a full family of the people, the Ma Mati Manush. I bow down my head to them. I salute to them. I salute to my jawans of this country. Again, I am saying, as an individual, I may not be here today or tomorrow, but the democracy will continue forever. The democracy is a winner always. The individual, the egoist attitude, it is a loser. How we have seen the audacity, even the scandaling attitude and all the scandalous, that should not be a democracy.
NDTV's cricket app, Android and iPhone. Fastest scorecard, special analysis, and much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.